A very good morning, student. Today we are going to see the human endocrine gland. In our previous class, we have seen some hormones of types of hormones in glands. Okay, now we are going to see the human endocrine gland. Here, human endocrine. What is the meaning of an endocrine? Here, endo, which means that is the inside, and crane, which means secretion. So, inside secretion of some of the gland of an human. That is the endocrine gland. Okay, here the secretion of gland, some hormones. Okay, let me see that one by one. I will say that laterly for a detailed further explanation. The first thing, here they are having a versatile communication from an organ. They are having a coordination between a coordination of biological function. A coordination of biological function, what is the coordination of biological function? The first thing, hormones are secreted from the gland. Okay, here a biological function, which means with the help of an organ, they are doing a digestion, or with the help of an organ, they are doing a reproduction, or with the help of an hormones, they are doing some transportations. Okay, so these are all the biological function. The first thing, they are having a versatile communication. Okay, and next one, a majorly endocrine system. Okay, if you are seeing an endocrine system, and not only endocrine, they are having exocrine also. Here, endo and exocrine. Okay, this is two major glands of a human, and not only for the human, in animals also they are having two glands like that, here endocrine and exocrine. If you have seen exocrine, they are not having any proper duct. Okay, so sorry, that is the endocrine, which are not having any proper duct, and exocrine, they are having a proper duct. So they are called as a duct gland, and here they are called as a ductless gland. Ductless gland, and here they are having a duct, right? So that is the duct. Here a duct, ductless, a duct appadina, they are having a separate vessels to transport the hormones. Here they are not having any separate vessels to transport the hormones. Here they are secrete the hormone in the bloodstream. Okay, but bloodstream la in the endocrine hormones are secrete panidom, just their bloods are transport the hormones to the entire parts of our body. Just they are sending the hormone to the targeted parts of our body. For example, the hormone secreted in the head portion, that is the pituitary gland. Just they are transported through the bloodstream and carried to the reproductive parts of our body. Just they are having a vast distance, right? But they are transported to the particular organ, that is a targeted organ. They are act as a specific organ, referred as a targeted organ. Okay, so this is the endocrine and exocrine. That is the overview about that endocrine and exocrine. Here the first thing, you are having one do you know part. Okay, the branch of biology deals with the study of endocrine gland. Here we say a study of endocrine, the name is endocrinology. A study of endocrine is endocrinology. Logy, which means study, and endocrine, that is the endocrine, we already say that meaning. And who is the father of an endocrinology na? That is the Thomas Edison. He is the father of an endocrinology. In English physiologist, they are having two English physiologists. The first person is W.M. Bayless, and next one E.H. Starling. Okay, he is the two person of English physiology introduce the term of an hormone. So this two person will introduce the term of an hormones. Okay, in that year of 1909. Okay, he first discovered the hormone secretion, this two person, and here Thomas Edison is the father of an endocrinology. Okay, let me move our first one, endocrine. Okay, here endocrine, they are having a specific ducts, the specific ducts, and exocrine, if you see the exocrine, they are not having a specific ducts. First, you have to say that exocrine, that is a small, two or three glands only. Let me say that first one, exocrine. Okay, here exocrine majorly consists of first one is a salivary gland. Okay, and next one is the mammary gland. Mammary gland. And next one is the sweat gland. So this is a three glands present in the exocrine. Just they are secreted in a small quantities. Okay, first one salivary gland. We are having a three type of salivary glands in the buccal cavity. As we know that we already studied in the 9th standard, a Langley, that is the sublingual gland, sublingual gland and something. Okay, three gland is there, no? A proximal gland like that. And next one a mammary gland. We are secrete the milk to the fetus. And next one sweat gland. As you know that is a sweat gland. Okay, they are here. The three glands, they are having a proper duct, which is the way to transport the secretion of hormone. That is, the glands secretion some liquids pass, right? They are having a separate duct. Through the duct only, they are passing the liquid particle. And now they have to move that endocrine. In the endocrine, the first thing we are having pituitary gland. The first one is pituitary gland, and second one we are having thyroid gland. And third one parathyroid gland. And fourth one pancreas. And also known as here sluts of Langerhans. That is a kinds of cell. I'll say you. And next one, adrenal gland. Have to note this in your observation note. And next one, the gonads. Here they are presence of two. First one is the testes, that is a male, and next one is the ovary, that is for a female. Okay, and next one, last gland is the thymus gland. Okay, here these are all the glands are present in the endocrine of a human. Here first you have to see that a pituitary gland. Here the pituitary gland, they are only responsible for the master gland. Here they say the master gland also. They are only a control the entire glands in our body. Okay, and here just act as a masters. Okay, to make the harmonious coordination of the other gland. And next one we are having the thyroid gland. Just they are present in a necretion. And here they are having a lack of a thyroid. They are suffer from the goiter, right? And next one they are having a parathyroid. Just pear shaped gland. They are present between the thyroid gland. And next one we are having the pancreas and the cells of Langerhans. Okay, pancreas are responsible for the time of a digestion to bring in your insulin and glucose level in our body. And next one we are having the adrenal gland. Here a major gland is the adrenal. They are only playing a major role at the time of an emergency situation. They are increasing the heartbeat rate. Okay, when you are going to an exam hall, before you are receiving a question paper, at the time you are going to receive a question paper, how you have to feel that you are increasing a heartbeat rate, a sweating, of excess of sweating in our body because of the adrenal gland. They are act as an emergency situation. Okay, and next one we are having the gonads. Here a gonads, which mean they are reproductive parts of our body. The first one is the testes and second one is the ovary. The testes are responsible for a male reproductive system, and a ovary are responsible for a female reproductive system. Okay, and here a last one is we are having a thymus gland. Here they are present in the chest region of a human body. Okay, and here the upper part of our chest, they are covering with the hormone. I will say what is the function for that. It just effects of immune function. Okay, immune system increase pannadirukanga laya. So that is a function of our thymus. So these are all the glands involved in the endocrine system. Let me see that one by one. The first one we are having a pituitary gland. Okay, before enter into our topic, I just show a video to you. Have to listen that video. It is easy to understand that a topic for an endocrine gland. Okay, just an overview about the gland. I have to see that video. Okay, let me see that.